knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we discussed the hydroformylation of olefins to produce linear aldehydes, which are important intermediates in the chemical industry. The smallest aldehyde that can be prepared by hydroformylation is propanal, a 3-carbon synthon. Acetaldehyde, which contains only 2 carbon atoms, is also an important industrial intermediate, with a yearly market of 1.4 million tons. Of course, it can't be prepared by hydroformylation because the product will contain the carbons in the olefin as well as the carbon in the carbonyl that inserts, and there are no olefins with only 1 carbon atom. The main approach to producing acetaldehyde is called the Wacker reaction. The name is derived from the company which discovered it, which launched in Germany in the late 1950s. Wacker was interested in ethylene as a precursor to functionalized monomers for plastic, and they discovered the oxidation of ethylene in a collaboration with another German chemical giant, Hoechst. The plant they opened in Berghausen in 1978 is still active and has produced over 5 million tons of acetaldehyde. The reaction operates at the gas-liquid interface. A gas mixture of ethylene and oxygen is pumped through an aqueous solution of the catalysts, which include sodium tetrachloropalladate and cupric chloride. The palladium species catalyzes the reaction of water with ethylene, which reduces the palladium 2 to palladium 0, and copper 2 catalyzes the oxygen-driven reoxidation to palladium 2. The reaction operates at fairly high temperature, around 100 to 130 degrees Celsius, and moderate pressure of 4 to 10 atmospheres. The mechanism has been studied in detail. The key step is the coordination of palladium 2 with ethylene. This scheme represents the mechanism in a simplified form. The chloropalladate is the main form in solution, but the actual catalyst is species 1, PdCl2. The palladium 2 catalyst first coordinates with the olefin to form intermediate 2. The coordination with palladium 2 makes the olefin electrophilic, and water can attack the coordinated olefin as a nucleophile to form a new CO bond, yielding 3. This undergoes a beta elimination of HPDCl to yield first the enol of acetaldehyde, which tautomerizes to give the more stable carbonyl form. The palladium species 4 is then converted back to 1 by the elimination of HCl and reoxidation by CuCl2 and oxygen. More precisely, first the copper 2 converts palladium 0 to palladium 2, and then oxygen reconverts copper 1 to copper 2, making the reaction catalytic both in copper and palladium. The step leading from 2 to 3 deserves special attention because we have not encountered it previously. We have mentioned that palladium 2 is very electrophilic, and coordination with olefins makes olefins also electrophilic. This is unusual because simple olefins are nucleophilic and react with electrophiles like bromine or Bronsted-Lowry acids. Olefin-palladium-2 complexes are important intermediates in catalysis. Their electrophilicity is a consequence of the bonding pattern illustrated here. The key interaction consists of an electron donation from the filled olefin pi bond into an empty d orbital, the LUMO of palladium-2. There is also some electron back donation from a filled d orbital of palladium, the HOMO, into a pi star olefinic orbital, but this is not enough to compensate for the donation of electron density by the olefin, which remains electron poor. We can therefore generalize the Wacker process as follows. The electron-poor olefin is attacked by a nucleophile from the backside of the olefin-palladium bond, yielding an intermediate which can undergo easy beta-hydride elimination to yield a substituted olefin. The palladium then needs to be reoxidized to re-enter the cycle. The net effect is replacement of a CH olefinic bond with a carbon nucleophile bond, with retention of configuration at the olefinic carbon if the olefin is substituted. In the classical Wacker case, the nucleophile is water. It is reasonable to assume that other nucleophiles can work as well, thus broadening the potential of this chemistry to other interesting transformations. For example, a carboxylate can be the nucleophile, and this reaction is an important approach to vinyl acetate, a valuable monomer for many commercial polymerization reactions. Alcohols can also function as nucleophiles, and under the acidic conditions used, ketals are usually formed from the intermediate vinyl ethers. This example shows that the Wacker reaction is not limited to ethylene, but can be extended to most alkenes. With asymmetrical alkenes, the problem of regiochemistry arises. The Wacker reaction follows Markovnikov selectivity, which means that the nucleophile ends up at the carbon which best stabilizes the incipient positive charge. In the first example, the secondary carbenium ion is more stable than the primary one. In the second example, the ester function destabilizes an incipient positive charge at the alpha position, and the opposite regiochemistry is observed. As for other examples, using amines as nucleophiles is problematic because they extensively bind palladium II salts and prevent olefin coordination with palladium. For this reason, amine derivatives with reduced basicity are used instead, like amides, carbamates, sulfonamides, and so forth. In the example shown here, a lactam, which refers to a cyclic amide, reacts in excellent yield to produce an enamide. Note the use of copper I salts as co-catalysts. They can also be used because they are oxidized in situ by the oxygen gas to copper II. Finally, the reaction can be used to form cyclic systems if the olefin and the nucleophile are part of the same molecule. Examples of cycloetherification and cycloamination are shown here. Note the use of sulfonamides as protected amines. The corresponding amine in this case does not work because it is too basic. There are many more complex examples of Wacker chemistry in the literature, but these few examples should suffice to illustrate the tremendous potential of olefin palladium II chemistry. In conclusion, in addition to its industrial use for the production of acetaldehyde, Wacker chemistry can be extended to a wide array of synthetic transformations, and it is still fertile ground for discovering new chemistry.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.